Do you have a most embarrassing Cambly moment?
So finally, I just kept staring at the camera.
What are the chances an avocado would be in my desk? Hi, everyone, and welcome to our Cambly Tutor Spotlight, where we talk to the best Cambly tutors and hear their stories. I'm Lynn, and I'm here with Michelle today. Michelle, welcome.
Thank you. Hello, everybody.
And I'm super happy that you're joining me today because you've been at Cambly for a long time, right?
Yes, actually, Lynn, I actually started in Cambly in 2015.
Oh my gosh.
So up until now, yeah.
Well, one of the reasons why I really wanted to talk to you is because I know you do Cambly Classic, you speak to adults, but you also do Cambly Kids, right?
Yes, that's true.
So how long had you been tutoring on Classic Cambly before you started with Cambly Kids?
I would say probably since it's been about 6 years with Cambly now, I'm going to guess roughly maybe around probably 4 years, 3.5 years before I actually started getting involved with the student,
okay.
The Cambly Kids students.
And was that a little bit nerve-wracking to apply for Cambly Kids, or was it an easy process? I don't work on Cambly Kids, so I don't really know the process like you would.
Yes. Cambly, I have to say, Cambly made it easy. They did all of the paperwork, so to speak, and they even showed me the platform that would be used. Mm-hmm. And I kept thinking, this is different from the adult platform. You don't have to prepare lesson plans. Cambly has everything there for you.
Yeah.
You just instruct.
Yeah.
So it was nerve-wracking. But once I saw that and made myself familiar with the lesson plans mm-hmm. that Cambly had provided, it was easier. The rest was just about letting your skills come out and just being friendly with the kids.
Yeah. Was that, do you remember your first Cambly Kids class? Did it go well?
I just actually remember my first turn of events with using with the kids. I was nervous, mm-hmm. but what one of the instructors kept telling me with Cambly is to make sure you use pictures. Lots of pictures, mm-hmm. lots of enthusiasm, mm-hmm. and, you know, anything just to keep the kids happy and to compliment. So I remember constantly doing that.
Yeah.
And the children responded, you know, they responded. So that made me relax a lot more.
That's awesome. But you have to kind of switch gears, right? If you're talking to an adult and you're in, you know, one particular teaching mindset for an adult, and then you have to be flexible and switch over to a kid's mindset. Was that a difficult adjustment for you, or was it fun? Was it a challenge?
It was definitely a challenge because I don't think of myself as a person who's normally good with kids.
Really?
So yes, I have to kind of make myself get into their mold to be able to instruct them. But once you kind of learn the kids and their personality, and they come regularly,
yeah.
once I kind of got the feel of their personality, you know, how they were, I just used the advice that Cambly gave me, and it made it a lot easier. So to answer you, it was a challenge in the beginning to switch modes.
Yeah. Yeah. And that actually surprises me when you say, oh, I didn't think I was great with kids. Mm-hmm. I think maybe on the Cambly Classic platform, a lot of tutors are surprised when kids use the adult or classic platform. Is there any advice you could give them?
Sure. I tell you what helps me a lot of times is just to be prepared just in case you get a child student.
Okay.
There's so much information out there for teaching children English, pictures, so many web pages that have interesting questions to ask kids of all ages, from small ones to teenagers, to be able to make it fun and at the same time instructive for them to leave the platform feeling like they have learned something in English for that day.
Yeah. That's really good advice. Because I think sometimes it's a surprise.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, you're in that mindset like, oh, I can talk about news, I can ask, you know, IELTS questions or something, and then all of a sudden it's you know, a seven-year-old or and, you know, and the answers that you get from children sometimes are one word answers, and you really have to dig sometimes. You really have to ask a lot of questions, I think, to get them to participate.
Yes, that is so true. Sometimes, you know, kids can get bored easily, even with pictures. Yeah. So I found that sometimes if the information that I'm using, it's not working, they're quiet, I have to discern if it's because of them not understanding the English or if they're simply bored. Yeah. Once I discern the reason, and if it's that they're just simply bored, I start to ask them questions about things they like. What did you do today? Who did you see? Tell me, show me something that you have in your room. Just anything, just to get them talking. And it usually always works. Always works.
That's excellent. Yeah, I remember one of my students who was a very reluctant speaker. And we used to play this game, and I called it Guess What's in My Desk. And I used to pick something out of my desk drawer. And I mean, it challenged their vocabulary. And sometimes the answers, their guesses would be so hilarious. One time, like, what's in my desk? And I'd pick out something and they'd say, an avocado? Like, what are the chances an avocado would be in my desk? But I loved playing those games because it really challenged them and got them involved too. That was fun.
I love that. I'm going to try that one too.
Very cool. Well, I like to ask everyone if they have a proudest Cambly moment.
Yes, I do. There were actually two students. This one particular student, when she first started, to be honest, I didn't understand anything that she said at all. It was very difficult, but she was so willing. And that was about 4 years ago. So now this student tells me that at her job, they have actually asked her to start translating for them in English.
Oh my God.
I couldn't believe it. And her level is so much better now that we can actually talk about deep things sometimes during the session. So that was very, very a good proud moment for me.
Yeah.
The second one is that there was a student from the Middle East that their English was also a little bit, you know, different. But about 4 years later, after much practicing, he mentioned that he applied for a job. The boss started the interview in Arabic and asked him if he would mind if he would finish it in English. He says, okay, no problem, go for it. The first set of questions, the boss finally stopped and says, okay, I don't need to go any further. I've heard enough. We'll be in contact with you. A week later, he got the job.
That's amazing.
I felt like I had a part in that. That was very good.
That's amazing. I think that that really is one of the best parts of the job. When it's something that you said, when you feel like you're a part of someone's success, I think that is, that's just the best. It's the best feeling, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
It's very, very nice.
Well, I don't know if I can ask this question, but you can say no. But we did a proud moment. Do you have a most embarrassing Cambly moment? I'll share mine if you share yours.
Oh, yes. At one point, there was this student and the English was very difficult to understand. But once again, they were a hard worker and it required so much energy. So I noticed we did the session. She felt very good afterwards and I gave her homework. So then, about an hour later, I felt the student has another reservation with me and I haven't had the time to go over her homework. So finally, I just kept staring at the camera and I'm sure she kind of noticed it. And she says, Michelle, I feel I have to tell you something. She says, I'm not who you think I am. And I go, really? How's that? She says, earlier, you actually spoke with my twin sister.
Oh.
And I was thinking, no way, because even the level of English was the exact same, the look and everything. It was like, maybe she has split personality thought between. So right away, both of the girls appear on the screen. And yes, she was right. But for me, that was the most embarrassing moment.
Oh my gosh. Well, at least you didn't say anything bad. Like, you didn't say anything bad about her sister. That would have been terrible.
So true.
Well, I'll tell you mine, and it's pretty embarrassing. It was probably, you know how you said it took you about a month to get comfortable with Cambly? Mm-hmm. it took me a lot longer. And I don't know why, but I would always have this like rush of nervous energy whenever a new student would call. So one day, it was probably 6 months. I'd probably been here for 6 months. And one day I finished my day and went out, walked my dog. I came back home and I heard the Cambly ringtone. And I thought, oh my gosh, I forgot to log out. So I ran in here and I probably looked terrible because I'd been outside. And I greeted this lovely woman from Brazil, but I had all this energy and I was talking with my hands. And I went like this. My hand caught my glasses, whipped my glasses off my face. They flew across the room and crashed against the wall and landed on the floor. And I was so mortified that I just didn't move and I didn't want to get up to get my glasses. I couldn't see anything. I couldn't see her. I was typing corrections like this the whole time. Like, I was mortified.
That is truly funny.
Oh my gosh. But, you know, I was really embarrassed, but the student, she stayed with me for 2 years and I was so grateful. Of course, the second time I met her was the first time I actually saw her because I had my glasses on, but I was pretty embarrassed.
That was true.
Hilarious. Oh my gosh. You know, something I noticed about you in your sessions, it doesn't matter if you're teaching an adult or a child. I noticed that you make them feel comfortable instantly. What do you like to do to make them comfortable? And that in turn, you know, makes them comfortable with you.
Oh, yes. You know, a smile is contagious. Simply smiling and your tone of voice, you know, the way you talk to them, mm-hmm. it gives them their dignity too. And then here at Cambly, we deal with so many different cultures.
Oh, yeah.
What might be one way in our country is perceived totally another way in a different country. So a smile, your tone of voice, and then ask them questions. Let them know, tell them something about yourself. Mm-hmm. Ask them questions. It kind of lets them know you're human, you know, you're here to teach them English. But you're human as well. And they'll just open up. Yeah. They will just open up. Yes.
That's fantastic. Well, another thing that I want to ask you is if you have a dream student, like who would make you lose your mind if they came into your classroom? Do you have a dream student?
You know, man, actually, I have to just be honest. I think all of the students are just so amazing. Even some of the students that require so much energy, I just love and admire the effort they put into this app and wanting to learn. So all of them just makes me feel so very special. And I'm just so happy that Cambly has allowed me to be a part of this for so long. And I just hope that I can keep going and meet more dream students, as you say.
That's fantastic. And you know, Cambly's lucky to have all the tutors, but I feel really lucky that I get to meet some of them. And I would love to hear your advice. If you have advice for Cambly tutors, whether they're new or maybe they've been here for a while, I would love to get your advice for tutors.
Oh, for sure. Just relax, prepare your lesson plan. Actually get to know the students and make them feel like you care, which I'm sure all of the tutors here at Cambly do. And once you do that, the rest comes so natural. You feel good, you feel relaxed, and you can instruct them better. And they learn something and take something away from the platform.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a great answer. Sometimes I think tutors get caught up. They get caught up in sort of the minutia of what we do here, and they forget to really connect. Sometimes they might be focused on some of the details instead of really connecting with the human being that's on the other side. I want to thank you for all the advice that you gave, and I want to thank you for your time and for talking to me. I feel like I met a new friend, so thank you so much for meeting me
too. Thank you for having me, Lynn. I really appreciate it.
It was my pleasure. And I want to thank everybody for watching today. If you have an interesting Cambly story, please let us know. Send us a message or tell us in the comments. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks, and we'll see you next time. Bye.